Hey ladies, so I wanted to send you this lesson recap on our first night, our first discussion night of our Becoming to Being women's group. This specific lesson was entitled Unpacking What's In You. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and start off here. We believe it's a great starter point for us. And I'm gonna read this little excerpt from our pastor's book, Jesus Didn't Die for Average People, because he explains it a lot better than of course I can. And he says, there is a quote that says, maybe the journey isn't so much about becoming anything, maybe it's about unbecoming everything that isn't really you, so you can be who you were meant to be in the first place. God is trying to get you to a place of unbecoming what you are not, what really isn't you. So this specific lesson is called Unpacking What's In You. And the goal of the lesson is to really kind of unpack what God placed in you and the things that you've placed in yourself. And so I'm definitely a visual learner, and so hopefully this kind of brings to life what we mean. And so here we go. So tonight we're gonna meet a woman named Megan. God has knit her together in her mother's womb and put some things inside her that she will need to bring out when the time is right. Let's see what God placed in Megan. So we've got our luggage here, and we're gonna say that this is Megan. So we're gonna see what God placed inside of her. You ready? All right. First, we have an umbrella. And so God placed his covering inside of Megan. And so with that, he had, you know, she's covered, she's protected, she's full of grace. She's graced to do what God has purposed her to do. So he placed inside of her his covering. Then we've got a belt. God placed his belt of truth inside of Megan, because as we know, we will go through life and different situations and begin to believe lies about ourselves and about others that are not true. And so God equips her with his belt of truth, which is a piece of the full armor of God. Then he placed inside of her his spirit. So this bottle water represents the spirit of God, the living water that flows inside of her. So he placed his spirit in her. Then he placed his comfort. So this blanket represents God's comfort, because as we know, Megan is gonna go through life and trials are gonna hit her, loneliness is gonna hit her, doubt is gonna hit her, fatigue is gonna hit her, grief is gonna hit her, as we are all faced with those situations in our journey, right? And so he provides already his comfort. And so he placed his comfort in her. Then he placed her originality. So this represents her authenticity in God. So Megan is one of a kind. One of the ladies at the last lesson said, she is a kingdom citizen, right? So this is her originality. He placed, there's no one like Megan. There's no one like you or I. God made our very own fingerprints different. Our DNA is different. And so he placed originality in each one of us and also in Megan. Then he also placed a cape. This is my son's cape. So it's a little jacked up. But he placed, we're gonna call this courage. So God placed courage inside of Megan and inside of every one of us as well. Because as we go through life, there will be moments where we will fear, but God says, fear not. And so this is a symbol of fear not. This is a symbol of courage. Be strong and of good courage. God says that several times. Be strong and of good courage. So this is the courage that God already placed inside of Megan. Then we've got this. This is a knife sharpener. So God placed a knife sharpener in Megan. This represents godly relationships that he has already predestined for Megan that will help her along her life journey, that will, as scripture says, iron sharpen iron. So these are those relationships that he intended that are purposeful, that will build up Megan in times when she needs it, and that she can actually help build up others likewise. So this is representative of the relationships, the godly, God-intended, purposeful relationships that that he purposed Megan to have. Then we've got this. This candle represents God placing his peace inside Megan. So peace is something that Megan is gonna need in her life's journey. Again, as trials and tribulations come up against her, he has already placed his peace within her, a peace that surpasses all understanding. All right, then we've got a cute little pump with some snake skin on it. It's a little fancy pump. This represents confidence. So he placed all the confidence inside of Megan that she is gonna need for her purpose. He has given her a confidence about her that can't be shaken, frankly. And so this represents a confidence, an inner confidence. Then we've got this. So God places his love inside of her. This is the heart puzzle. And so he placed his love inside of her. A love that he will be on the throne of her heart, or should be on the throne of her heart. But he gave her a soft heart, not a hardened heart. And he placed his love inside of her. Then we've got this. So God placed his strength inside of Megan. So he says, Megan, I know that there will be times when you feel weak, but my strength is made perfect in your weakness. So he placed his strength inside of her. God does so knowing that there are times where our flesh may fail and we may feel weak, but in him we are made strong. Okay, so God placed this. And this is all of the gifts that he has placed in Megan. And so what's unique about the gifts that he's placed in Megan and in each one of us is that that they're unique. They're unique to ourselves. And here's what I love even more about our unique gifts is that they're just every year that we kind of get older and go more into our purpose and kind of learn more about ourselves, in Him, there's just so many gifts to discover. It's just unending. New gifts are being discovered every time we seek Him. And so this right here is such a blessing, because He placed so many gifts in each one of us. And He placed these gifts in Megan with the hope that she would seek Him on how to be a good steward of them. And she can just keep opening. It's like Christmas every single day for Megan and for ourselves. All right, and lastly, He placed a crown. This represents Megan's position. She is seated in heavenly places with Christ Jesus. She is a daughter of the King. She was born, that's her birthright. She was born into the kingdom. She was born royalty. And so God placed this inside of Megan so she would never forget her position as the daughter of a King. All right, but here we go, y'all. Here's where it gets real, right? Now Megan goes through life and different situations occur, and she begins to pack away some things of her own. So God packed her up and says, Megan, you're ready for your purpose. You're ready to show the earth my glory. Oh, but Megan goes through middle school and starts to realize that other girls are getting more attention than her. She is shy, and the boys are starting to notice her friends and not her. She realizes that her body is different and starts to pick apart all the things that she is not. So she packs away her very own insecurity. Then Megan's parents go through a divorce. Her whole foundation of family is shaken, and she begins to pack away doubt, anger, loneliness. She gets a little older and involves herself in a serious relationship. This is the part where we say, don't do it, Megan. Don't do it, Megan. She involves herself in a serious relationship. She is so in love, and all of a sudden, the relationship doesn't work out. They break up, and she is left heartbroken, picking up all the pieces. So she packs away brokenheartedness. She packs away lack of self-confidence, loneliness, unworthiness. Then she finishes up school and begins to see everyone around her moving into other things. Businesses, jobs, degrees, families. And she begins to compare her purpose with those around her. So she packs away comparison and fear and worry. And Megan reaches a point in her life where she just feels so weighed down. So not only is she weighed down by these things that are very weighty, but they have no substance. So these are all things that we pick up on our own, that we pack away in our suitcase, and they have absolutely no substance, but they're very weighty. And so these things begin to weigh on us. Now, imagine, we gave this example. If you've ever seen a person in the airport and they have so much luggage, like they look like they're traveling for the year. They've got like two luggages, they've got handbags, and they're just kind of like struggling, and they're kind of like trying to get all their luggage and pull their luggage with them. That's similar to what we do. And we're trying to be purposeful. We're trying to find our purpose even, but we're carrying around so much weight that God did not intend on us to carry. And so she begins to shed all of the weight and unpack all of the unnecessary things that she is allowed to slow her down and slow down her journey of becoming what God created her to be, to actually being that woman. And so a lot of us are Megan, right? In our own ways. God has filled us up, packed us full with things that we're gonna need for our purpose and being the woman that he has called us to be. But whatever life has thrown our ways, and each of us have a different story, we've packed away very unnecessary but very weighty things that have slowed us down. And so the purpose of really this lesson is to dive into the things that we've packed away. And so with this lesson, you guys also got that that kind of image of or worksheet of packing what's in you. And so there's two sides to this. And this is really kind of your homework. I've been doing this on my own. And it's really been helpful because I've realized that I've really kind of unpacked some very unnecessary things that God never intended me to. He says to lay down every weight, that so easily besets us. One translation says lay down every sin, but really it's a weight that so easily besets us. He says in his word that lay down our burdens, that his yoke is easy, right? And his let me get that right, y'all. He says his yoke is easy, his burden is light. And so really the purpose of this lesson is to recognize, one, what do I need to unpack, and two, what did God pack in me? And so I don't mind sharing some of mine. We shared ours, and we'd be happy to share more if you want to dive deeper into this. But some examples that I had on my own worksheet as I kind of took some time, and this is a working sheet, a living working sheet, in that I mean that you don't have to know everything that God, that you need to unpack tonight or whenever you sit down to pray about these things and write them down. Really every day or every new season, every new year, you might have picked up some things, or God might reveal to you some things that you need to unpack. But I'll share mine just in the spirit of transparency and hopefully to encourage you to really take this seriously, to really sit down with yourself and have an open conversation with yourself and with God, and have him reveal these things to you. Anyway, so here's what he's revealed to me. What do I need to unpack? Lisa, I need to unpack insecurities, lack of confidence, fear, perfectionism, feeling like everything has to be perfect. I need to unpack self-doubt and also procrastination. Those are all things that as of right now, I believe God is one, that they're weighing me down, and two, that God wants me to unpack. And so on the opposite side of it, the fun side, because this side is not that fun, to really dive in and see what's been weighing us down for so long. And so this side is the funner one, right? What did God pack in me? He packed in me, Lisa, boldness. He packed confidence. He packed love. He packed worthiness. He packed creativity. He packed forgiveness. He packed victory, and he packed worship. So those are all the things that I believe that God has revealed to me that he's packed in me for my purpose and my journey in becoming to being. So, again, we highly encourage you to sit down and to really think about these things. Some of the things may be the same things that he packed in Megan. His truth, his her position, his covering, all those things. And so with that, I just want to go ahead and just pray with you, for you, for a minute. if you don't mind, before I let you go, to do your own homework on unpacking what's in you. God, we thank you for tonight, God. We thank you so much for the women who have taken the time and even watched this lesson, this video. God, thank you so much that they are fearfully and wonderfully made, God, that you have packed so much inside of them, Lord. Thank you so much for the offering, the opportunities, God, to discover those things, God. God, I just pray right now that you would just reveal those things that they have maybe carried for far too long that you never intended for them to carry, oh God. Show them how to unpack those things gently, Lord, and with grace, Father. God, thank you so much that you have packed your covering, God, your word, God, your truth in them, oh Lord. Thank you so much that you've packed their position in you, Father, that they are a king's daughter, oh God. They are royalty, God. Help them to see that, Holy Spirit. God, we thank you again for the women that have watched this, God, and we just pray that you would just bless them, oh God. Meet every single need. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, ladies. Well, that's it for me. I apologize for the screams in the background, my busy house in the background. I apologize. However, we'll see you guys next time we meet. Bye.